Hey, I have been asked by multiple people, I get asked this all the time, on how I keep my hair for a week. And I want to share with you how I keep it for a week and how I keep it healthy and long. Because when you have really long hair, it's really hard to keep it healthy. And you have to really work hard at it. Because if not, you will want to cut it off because it looks so bad. So, the first thing that I do is before I do anything, and today I'll just go ahead and give you let you know what I've done with my hair. Last night I washed it and went to bed on a towel, or I think I might have air dried it, I can't remember. But so today was really hot and humid, and I did a workout, so I know by morning my hair is not gonna look good up here. So normally what I do every night, and I really do have to do this every night, I take baby powder, and my husband bought me this one because it don't have a lot of bad, harsh chemicals, and he probably got it at Walmart. But what I do is I just sprinkle in a little bit on my part. Let me turn it on. It's off. So I just take it and I sprinkle it in. I gotta look in my mirror. Look in that iPad. I can't see. So I just sprinkle it in, and I try not to do too much. Sometimes I do a little bit more. But I've just put it in kind of all over my hairline where people might see my hair. And in the crown. And if you need to do the back of your hair, if you wear your hair up, you can do that. So after that, you just raise upside down and work it in the roots really good. And I usually do this in a hurry, because I'm always in a hurry. You gotta rub it off your skin. But I already washed my face, so I don't want baby powder all over my face. But after that, the second thing that I do is I like to use a hair oil. This one is this brand. I got it out of an Ipsy bag. It does work good. I really like it. I sell a brand called Loma. It's organic. I do prefer it more. It's just downstairs in my salon, and I'm trying to use up what I have. And but it repairs. So the oil basically is going to repair my hair at night while I'm asleep and help it to be silky and shiny and look manageable. If I don't do this, my hair literally looks like it's broke off. It will be broken off, and it literally looks like a rat has chewed my ends. That's how bad it looks. If I do not put oil on my hair and then go to bed, it looks terrible. And it makes me want to cut my hair off. And so I have to do this in order to keep my hair. And so I basically use a pump, two pumps, and I work it in. And I'll work it in really fast, because that friction helps, it just helps push it through on my hair. And I feel like that's a good bit. You can kind of tell by feel and by look. By morning, you won't see this oil at all. It will be sucked up. So if you get too much, it's okay. Because by morning, you won't even notice. So I just rub it in really good. I don't brush it in, because typically, I haven't today, I've not curled my hair, but typically I'll curl my hair once a week. I'm going to curl it in the morning when I wake up. And so after that, I don't brush my hair. I'm going to brush it before I curl it, but after I curl it, I'm not going to brush it anymore. I'll do this exact same routine with the baby powder, with the oil. I put it in on my ends, rub it through. It just makes my curls bouncy again. And I just usually end up rubbing the oil on my hands, on my arms. It's pretty good for you, so there's no point in washing it off. So after you feel like you've got that oil in pretty good, like I said, by morning it'll be sucked up. By morning with the baby powder, it will be sucked up. You might look like you've got baby powder in your hair at night, but by morning you won't even see it. Your hair will be all fluffy and pretty. And the reason I use baby powder instead of dry shampoo, for me, dry shampoo just doesn't do anything. It doesn't do any good. It smells good, but I've got hair perfume for that purpose. I feel like baby powder smells good, and I you know, baby powder is just as bad as dry shampoo. Dry shampoo is an aerosol and you're breathing in chemicals. So it's lesser of the two evils, I guess. And it just helps me to use baby powder because I don't have to wash my hair every day. And I don't have time to wash my hair every day. I don't want to wash my hair every day. And it's not good for me to wash my hair every day. And it's not practical for my lifestyle. If I'm going to have long hair, it has to look good. And it has to fit my lifestyle. That's just the way it is, or I'm going to chop it off. So in order for me to maintain that, I have to do the baby powder and the oil. Because if I don't, my hair looks terrible, especially if I don't curl it. So like you girls out there that like when you come in and you want to cut 1 or 2 inches off of your hair, I totally get why you want to. Because if I don't do this to my regimen and I don't curl my hair every day, I'm with you. I want to cut my hair off. But if I do this and I can go a week, you know, my hair, I feel like it looks good and I'm not as tempted to cut it. And in the summertime, I probably will wash my hair twice a week just because it's hot and you get sweaty and it's just gross. But in the wintertime, I definitely can go a week. Also on the whole week deal, if you've got natural hair and you don't have highlights, you're probably not going to be able to go a week. Like, there's no way. I can't go a whole week unless I've got highlights in my hair. So basically, that's why I have highlights in my hair, is because it gives me body. It helps me to not have to style my hair as much. Helps my hair not to look as dirty. And it brightens my face up. It just looks a little bit better, in my opinion. So that's a lesson on why I do all those things. And then the third thing I do before I go to bed, and this is an absolute must. All three of these just about are an absolute must, for real. Like I said, I'm always in a hurry. I usually don't take a lot of pains with this because I want to go to bed. I don't want to play with my hair, and I don't want to have to spend a whole lot of time on my hair. So the third thing I do is I use an old-fashioned scrunchie, the cloth kind, or like this one because it's stretchy. And it's not an elastic band. I don't suggest that you use the black elastic bands because they're a little bit too, they're too tight. They're too, it's going to pull your hair. And it might cause, that can cause baldness. So, like, don't ever pull your hair up really tight like that. That can cause you to go bald. That'll pull your hair out. If you ever see me in a bun, like when I'm at work or out, I always pull this out because it takes the tension off of that. And I don't ever want to go bald right there. And I feel like that can cause that. I've actually seen that cause that in my career. So when I put my hair up at night, I typically use these. These don't work as good because my hair is pretty heavy and thick. And actually my hair has been thinning out, so I do have a little bit of a difficult time if I don't have curl in my hair. Like last night, I went to bed and I hadn't curled my hair at all. It had air dried. I had zero product in it. And usually I always have some type of volumizer or something to have a grip. So like last night, my hair kind of kept falling out of my scrunchie. But the rest of the week it won't, because it's like as the week goes on, it's going to get more and more body and more volume. Usually by day 4, my hair is looking, in my opinion, pretty good. So I'll just show you how I put it up at night. I just basically put it up in a pretty high bun because I don't want to sleep on my bun. I want to put my hair, you know, up on my head, which everybody can pretty much figure that out. You don't want to sleep on your bun. So I just kind of roll it around, keeping my ends smooth. And then I just put this scrunchie around it. And basically that's it. And then of course I'm going to pull that out a little bit because it just hurts. So if I don't, then it's just habit. But that's basically what I do. I go to sleep like that. And because if I don't, trust me, by morning, my hair's ruined. It's dry. It's terrible. It looks fried. It looks damaged. I'm not sure what I do in my sleep, but I'm apparently pretty rough. And I even have tried sleeping on a silk pillow. I've tried, you know, all that good stuff. But that's what I do. And in the morning, I basically just take this out and shake my hair. Sometimes I'll brush the top a little bit to just fluff up my roots, but that's what I do. Tomorrow, I will brush my hair and curl it. And I don't use a whole lot of hairspray because it does, for me, my hair won't last as long, but sometimes, you know, it lasts better if you don't use hairspray, but I just like how hairspray looks, and I just think it looks pretty, so that's why I use it. But I hope this helped you. I've been wanting to do this for about a year. I've just been so tired and so busy, but I finally just made myself because I've had a lot of people ask, and I really want to help people keep their hair healthy and keep it long and keep your hair to where you feel confident about it, not wanting to chop it off. So this is my tricks, and I hope it helps you.